Good morning, Tigers, and welcome back to the world's greatest elementary school. This is a short week of school because of the Thanksgiving holiday break on Thursday and Friday. We'll have normal full days of school today and tomorrow with normal dismissal at 3:20. And then on Wednesday, we dismiss at 12:20. Lunch will be served, but each grade level will have early lunch times, and then we will not have school on Thursday or Friday for Thanksgiving. Classes will resume on Monday, November 27th. We hope that you and your families have a fun and restful Thanksgiving holiday break.
Yes, happy Thanksgiving, everybody. Hey, last Friday, our fourth and fifth graders on the Shadow Lake volleyball team participated in the district elementary volleyball tournament at Summit Trail Middle School. We wanted to congratulate all of our Tigers who participated and also say a huge, big thank you to Mrs. Na for her leadership of the Shadow Lake volleyball team. Here are some pictures of last week's volleyball tournament.
All right, Tigers, we are a little over halfway through the month of November, which means we are halfway through the PTA's Piece of the Pie fundraiser. We have 10 days left to try and get friends and family members to sponsor our Tigers and support the amazing Shadow Lake PTA and all of the events and programs that they put on here at Shadow Lake. Remember, our goal is $15,000. So far, we have filled in the first pie slice, which means at our December Spirit Assembly, we are gonna have one lucky staff member, me, getting pied. But Tigers, if we keep bringing in donations and filling up pie slices, we'll also get to pie Mr. Abby, Mr. Schlag, Mr. Bubbles, Mrs. Bradley, and Mr. Selsky. Remember, if you get a cash or check donation, bring that into school with one of the pie slices with your name on it with the donation amount. If you get an online donation, the PTA takes care of writing on the pie slice. Let's keep filling up that poster and that big pie.
I'm excited to see you get pied, and possibly me and a whole bunch of other teachers. Hey, you guys, the holiday toy and gift drive sponsored by the Maple Valley Food Bank is going on between now and December 1st. Remember, we're collecting unwrapped toys, $25 gift cards, and food items. Our goal is to collect 500 toys and 50 gift cards. Let's keep on coming together as a Shadow Lake caring community and help out others in need.
All right, Tigers, even though it's a short day on Wednesday, we still have Workout Wednesday. Last week, we had 231 Tigers complete over 1,200 laps.
Yes.
Mr. K's class had a total of 25.8 miles, and one student got 18 laps.
Wow.
Whoa, let's see how many we can get out there this Wednesday and how many miles we can log. Mr. Abby, what's going on with the lunch menu?
All right, Tigers, here is this week's lunch menu. Today is cheesy pull apart. Tomorrow, Tuesday, is gonna be chicken nuggets, and then Wednesday is corn dog. Remember, Thursday and Friday, no school because of Thanksgiving break. We do have lunch bunch on Wednesday, and then recess club just Tuesday. Remember, we don't have school on Thursday, so no recess club that day, but we do have those going on in the Tiger Den. And then, just like we heard, don't forget, get out there on Wednesday for Workout Wednesday.
Okay, Tigers, it's time to recognize more of our amazing Tigers who have been earning Tiger Paw tickets and were selected in this week's drawing. For kindergarten, we have Poppy and Mrs. Stamp's class, Paxton and Mrs. Hurley's class, Isla and Mrs. Belmondo's class, and Zaid and Mrs. K's class. Nice job, kindergartners.
All right, moving on to our first grade winners. Congratulations to Bryson in Ms. DeGroot's room. Peter, you were selected in Mrs. Hansen's class. Etika, you are the winner in Mrs. Yassine's. Ruvum, you are the winner in Mrs. Unruh's class. And then Liam, congratulations, you're the winner in Mrs. Nelson's classroom.
Nice job, first graders. Moving on to second grade. We have Ainsley in Mrs. Kortenkamp's class, Shannon in Ms. LaClesche's class, Tristan in Mrs. Shireman's room, and Barrett in Mrs. Meek's class.
Way to go, second graders, all right? Moving on to third grade. Congratulations to Caroline, you're the winner in Mrs. Boyle's room. Brayden, you were selected in Mr. McMaster's class. Melanie, you're the winner in Mrs. McAllen's room. And Mackenzie, you were selected in Mr. Schlag's classroom.
All right, nice job, third graders. Moving on to fourth grade, we have Kylie in Mrs. Bradley's class, Olivia in Mrs. Moffitt's room, and Jack in Mrs. Isley's class.
All right, and last but not least, our fifth grade winners. Cole, you were selected in Mr. K's room. William, you're the winner in Mr. Selsky's Mrs. Licious class. And then Taylor, congratulations, you're the winner in Mrs. Heater's room.
Nice, all right, winners, when it is convenient for your class, you'll get sent down to the office to pick up your prize from the Tiger Paw Treasure Chest. Okay, Mr. Abbey, what's going on with story time?
All right, today, Mrs. Smith, our Shadow Lake librarian, is reading a story called Maddie's Fridge.
All right, Tigers, we hope you all have a great week and a fun and relaxing Thanksgiving holiday. Remember,
it's a great day to be a tiger.
Hey, Tigers! Welcome back to Storytime. I'm Mrs. Smith. Really excited to read another story. This was an award-winning story written several years ago, 2015. Oh my goodness, that was a long time ago for some of you. All right, this is called Maddie's Fridge. And I chose this story because we have the toy drive going on this week and the food drive going on this week. And so this book is always just a great reminder of how we can take care of each other, look after each other, and show kindness whenever we can. All right, here we go. Turn this down just a little bit. It says, when Sophia and Maddie played at the park, they stretched their toes to the sky, they climbed to the top of the ladder, and flew off the end of the slide. They stayed until the buildings grew long shadows and even the taxis stopped honking. Let's play on the climbing wall, Maddie said. No way, Sophia said. I can't reach. Yes way, Maddie scooted up to the top of the wall. Your turn. Sophia put a foot on the bottom rock, grabbed with one hand and stretched, but she couldn't reach the next hold. Sophia's stomach growled. I give up. Let's get a snack. No way, Maddie said. Let's stay here. Yes way. Sophia ran to Maddie's building and raced up the stairs. Wait, Maddie ran after her. Maddie was the best climber, but Sophia was the fastest runner. Sophia swung open the door of Maddie's fridge. What have you got? We have milk, Maddie said. I'm saving it for Ryan. He's still little. Why doesn't your mom go to the grocery store? Sophia asked. We don't have enough money. But what if you get hungry? We have some bread, Maddie said. I guess I'll go home to eat, Sophia said. Please don't tell anyone, Maddie said. Okay. Promise? I promise. Sophia ran home past the bookstore and the grocery store. The sun went down behind the buildings and took all the colors with it. Good timing, Mom said. Dinner's almost ready. Luis was wrestling on the floor with Pepito. Sophia opened the refrigerator door. Pepito peeked inside. Sophia's fridge was full of milk and eggs and tortillas and cheese and lettuce and jam and salsa and tofu and even half a can of dog food. Here you go, Mom said. Sophia and Luis each had a plate of fish and rice. Mom had a plate of fish and rice. Even Pepito had his bowl of dog food, with a little bit of fish and rice. Maddie and Ryan only had some bread and a small carton of milk. Sophia couldn't tell Mom. She had to keep her promise to Maddie. "Not fish again," Louise said. "I want cheesy pizza bombs." "Cheesy pizza bombs are a treat," Mom said. "Fish is a good source of protein." "Is fish good for kids?" Sophia asked. "Yes," Mom smiled. "Fish is perfect for kids." That night, Sophia had an idea. "Yuck," Maddie said the next day. "Oh," Sophia said, "double yuck. Fish may be good for kids, but fish is not good for backpacks." After school, Sophia and Maddie raced to the climbing wall. Sophia got there first, but Maddie scrambled past her to the top of the wall. Sophia stretched and stretched. "Keep trying," Maddie said. "You'll get it." "I can't." Sophia jumped down. "It's too high." That night, Sophia, Luis, and Mom ate frittata. Papito had his dog food with a little bit of frittata. Maddie and Ryan still had an empty refrigerator. Sophia couldn't ask for help. That would break her promise. She had to try again. "Are eggs good for kids?" Sophia asked. "Not as good as cheesy pizza bombs," Louise said. "Cheesy pizza bombs are a treat," Mom said. "Eggs are good for you." After dinner, Sophia packed eggs for Maddie and Ryan. So she tried to give her the fish. Now she's trying to give her the eggs. "Yuck," Maddie said. "Double yuck," Sophia said. "Eggs may be good for kids, but eggs are not good for backpacks." Sophia and Maddie raced to the climbing wall. Sophia won again, but Maddie shot past her to the top of the wall. Sophia grabbed one hold, reached for the next, and came down with a thump. "That happens sometimes," Maddie called. "This is impossible," Sophia said. "Keep trying," Maddie said. "You'll get it." That night, Sophia, Luis, and Mom had burritos. Papito had his dog food with a little bit of burrito and no salsa. Maddie and Ryan still had an empty fridge. Sophia wished she hadn't promised Maddie. "Are burritos good for kids?" Sophia asked. "Burritos are very good for you," Mom said. "Not as good as," Luis started to say. "You should pay attention to nutrition like your sister," Mom said. The next morning, Sophia put two burritos in her backpack, along with tortillas, beans, and cheese, and even some milk. "No thanks," Maddie said. "You haven't even looked," Sophia said. "Is it fish?" Maddie asked. "No." "Is it eggs?" "No." "Is it gross?" "I don't know," Sophia said. Maddie shook the backpack. Something sloshed. "Let's look together," Maddie said. 1, 2, 3, go. "Burritos are good for kids and good for backpacks. Do you want some milk?" Sophia asked. "Thanks," Maddie said, "but I'll save the milk for Ryan." Sophia and Maddie raced to the climbing wall. Sophia won as usual and tried to climb. "You can do it," Maddie said. "Take my hand." "Woohoo! I made it to the top," Sophia shouted. "We're the tallest kids in the park," Maddie said. "Thanks for helping me, Maddie. I couldn't do it alone." Maddie shrugged. "That's what friends are for." After they finished playing, Sophia walked past the bookstore and the grocery store. She thought and thought and thought. Her own fridge was full of milk and juice and chicken and yogurt and bread and carrots and even half a can of dog food. Maddie's fridge only had two tortillas and a cup of beans and a bit of cheese and a little more milk than before. Sophia didn't want to break her promise, but she couldn't help Maddie alone. Sophia told. She hoped Maddie wouldn't be mad. "I'm glad you told me," Mom said. Let's see what we can do together. They loaded grocery bags with milk, flour, chicken, carrots, sugar, oil, and even frozen meat and vegetables. Luis pulled his package of cheesy pizza bombs out of the freezer. He thought and thought and thought some more. Then he put his cheesy pizza bombs in Maddie and Ryan's bag. "For a treat," he said. At Maddie's apartment, the moms talked, Luis and Ryan played. Sophia and Maddie ran to the park. "You broke your promise," Maddie said. "I'm sorry," Sophia said. "Are you mad?" "A promise is important," Maddie said. "You're more important," Sophia said. "I wanted you to have milk too," Maddie smiled. "Are we still friends?" Sophia asked. "Always," Maddie said. "Double always," Sophia said. "Cheesy pizza bombs," Luis yelled. "Our moms made cheesy pizza bombs for a treat." Sophia and Maddie raced up the stairs. Sophia slowed down so they could run together. That's what friends are for. There we go. And that is Maddie's fridge. All right, Tigers, I hope you enjoyed that story. I just love that story. I think it's just such a good reminder, especially at this time of year. We're always reminded of how we can help others that might have less than us. So this is a great week to bring food for the food drive, toys for the toy drive, but we can do that all year round. We don't have to just do it in November and December. So always be kind to your friends because you just don't know what's going on at home. So love each other, be kind, and remember, it's a great day to be a tiger.